Hello, Nana here. Welcome back to Grim Dawn. We're playing with a Drain Essence Dev Knight on Hardcore Ultimate Difficulty. Today we're gonna go after Commander Lucius. There's a couple of enemies on the way. So last episode we ended up hitting level 94 and equipping a bunch of new items. It mostly benefited my defenses, lost a little bit of offensive ability, but in the bigger picture, no, defense is more important than offense. And once your defense is solid, you can focus back on offense. So it's gonna work out in the end. So after I was done recording, I started looking at the blacksmiths and what I could craft there, and I had a look at all the mythical level 94 craftable components, and I encountered the mythical Sanctus Crest, which is an epic medal that grants a lot of very interesting modifiers. A percentage bonus to shield block chance, which if you combine it with the new shields that we have here, this also grants 10% shield block chance. This is another 6%, so we now have a 72% chance to block attacks. So that is going to be rather significant. I think before this we were down at, that should have been 56%. So we're blocking quite a lot more. We block a little bit more damage every time we do block, so that is nice. And then there's a bonus to pierce, ether, and chaos resistance, as well as elemental resistance. And then there's also a bonus to the maximum resistance for Pierce, Fire, Cold, and Lightning, all 4%. It's also a bonus to Aura of Censure, that's an Inquisitor skill, Mock Dragon's Pact, that is a Shaman skill. But even without the skill bonuses, this is a terrific item. I had to shift a lot of my augments over to compensate for the loss of poison resistance. It is now at exactly 80%, so it is topped off, but there's nothing else to spare. But I did manage to max out all the other resistances as well. So pierce resist is now at 87%. It also got a little bit of a bonus to the limit, thanks to the Obelisk of Menhir over here. That's another 3%. The elemental resists are nicely topped off, fire being just 1% overcapped, bleed 24% overcapped, ether is now 1% overcapped, and chaos is only 2% overcapped. And yeah, there's a lot of poison resistance spread over the gear now. And the Slith's Venom is now also in multiple places, just to compensate for all the poison resists. There's now an anti-venom solve in here rather than a silk swatch, which boosts pierce and bleed. So a lot of shifting around, but eventually all the resists are now capped off. I did have to put a wardstone in here just to get the fire resistance maxed out. Otherwise I would have preferred to put an ectoplasm in here, but can't have all the things at all the time. And at some point we're gonna get new gear, better gear, improved gear. And I'm sure that ectoplasm is gonna come eventually. For now though, we're maxed out on resists. We're doing pretty good in terms of block chance, in terms of damage blocked.
That skill's not ready.
And more we are done for, or ready for the endgame and for some of the interesting fights. Hey, were you sneaking up on me, Asperia the supporter? Well, for that, you deserve to die. If it ended up having killed me, then of course I would have deserved to die as well, because, well, if the enemy managed to sneak up on you, then obviously you weren't paying enough attention. Harsh, but pretty darn true. Let's pick up the supplies first. So we head up over here. Hello, everybody. So level 99, every once in a while there's a 100 in there. Hey, is that a... that's a secret space. With a couple of small components. And the explosives are ahead. Usually there's a bit of guard. Yep, you are reflective. You are not even a hero. Well, not too impressed with reflective enemies. We re-sustain ourselves so well. Reflect is just not an issue. So as I said, we just do lots of small pieces of damage very rapidly. So we get a lot of leech back that way. Rather than doing a very large hit that leeches, because then there might be some issue with reflection. Okay, hello. Some reanimator died. They're the only ones that open their mouth when they die, and I think that is exactly specifically because the first boss that you have to kill is the reanimator in the cave. I think that's the only reason why the voiceover line is there. But still, it's pretty fun. Let's just take these out. I mean, if they can't attack me, then that is perfectly fine. Great. But now we know there is loot waiting over there. It's funny if you taunt them that they run around. And there is the secret door to get into this little jail. So come on, Lucius. Pretty strong foe, usually. We're capped out on ether resistance, so one of his big weapons is of course doing ether damage, where at on veteran at this point in the game, your ether resistance might not be maxed, so he ends up hurting a lot. In my case, resistances are capped, so I think he is... It's gonna be dangerous, but not superbly dangerous. I hope I judged that one correctly. Now we need to go grab that one. We go over here, over there. And then we are nearly there. Hello there, Dominator. You look to be on fire today. And there is all the ether stuff of Lucius. His transformation was a bit more potent than others have. Okay, let's see. Level 100 Lucius. See if we can get a bit of space here. Let's just not stand where he puts stuff on the floor. Okay, face tanking his flamethrower. Okay, face tanking that one. Just I'm intentionally trying to see how far I can push this. Okay, he's raging. Let's just reflect a bit of the damage back at him so far. Haven't felt a need to use Overguard. Okay, he's now getting very angry. Let's Overguard a little bit here.
I'm out of energy.
Okay, out of energy. That's a dangerous thing. I think I might have actually lost an aura. I'm not quite sure which one. That's always an issue. That's the one downside of running out of energy. You tend to lose some random auras. We lost spectral binding. That's a lot of extra health and offensive ability and turtle shell. So yeah, that was not a good one to lose. And we lost counter-strike with stone form. So that was actually a very potent piece of the defense that was lost there. Luckily it was only in the end, but it is important. Keep an eye on your energy. Don't do like I do and forget about it. Because if you lose auras, you lose part of your survivability and potentially that could cost you your character. Okay, well that was nice and easy. So we've got some time to push things forward a little bit. Take out these guys. See if we can find the next waypoint in the necropolis. Okay, we blew this one up, then we can portal. Just say hello to the people here. And then after that, I think he should be saying something to me. What do you want? We will head to the necropolis. That's what I said just a minute ago. Here they are. Homestead lost some reputation. That's the annoying thing about some of the main quest lines losing your reputation with some factions. What is it? I will deal with the witch. The witch in the dungeon. But yeah, we're now back to being honored with Homestead, so we need to kill more beasties. Then might as well... Oh. Side with the witch. Oh, actually, we have some good reputation here. Yep, I'm maxed out here. Still gotta get myself a stack of these. Figured I'll just get the mandates for a new character. I can just pick up a mandate and I think you can consume them. And then, you know, your new character will have 100% reputation gain with all the relevant factions. Figured might as well just buy it, put it in a stash, and then never have to think about it again. Ooh, ether resistance. Did I not pick that one up? I did not pick that one up. Let's get a nice stack of these as well, because ether resistance, it is always helpful to be able to apply that. Fire and cold. Well, we got space here. I might as well. Probably not gonna use them, but might as well. And then cold and lightning. No, just to round it out. We got these. Okay, so overflowing with the augments here, so might as well do that. Just get some small stacks. But notice I spent quite some money recently. The mandates, they're 12,000 each, so if you buy 10, that's 120,000. I bought 6 of these stacks. But also the Mythical Sanctus crest, it's 250,000, I think. And I crafted 2. And this is the one that had just slightly better rolls on the resists, allowing me to actually top things off exactly. As well as the shield block chance, it was 6% here rather than 4. There's some variance in all of those stats. Let's see, anything else in here that is helpful? Let's buy some of these things now so I don't forget about it. And there's gonna be some shifting of resist. Ooh, look at that. Ether and chaos, 8%. And this is for offense, so that is a better version of the essence of Catan, in my opinion, from a purely defensive perspective, since you boost your ether resist with it rather than just the chaos. And yeah, for now that solves it. Let's put that one in the collection there. We were friends, and friends we shall remain. Yay, I pissed off the Black Legion. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. What's wrong? I will gather your things for you. It's still too bad that you can't use the items from your stash, but we'll figure that one out. Yeah, I'll do that at some point. For now, let's go back to the portal and then carry on. Right, let's be alert.
That skill's not ready.
There's of course a portal into the void, which has some interesting things. If you encounter it, probably should go in. If we don't encounter it, then we'll see about it. So you are reflective. There's a lot of bodies around, but none of them look heroic, so that's okay. Some energy definitely draining rather quickly. Hey, you, Glacierborn. Oh, Gilliston the Reborn. Not Glacierborn, that's a different one. Yeah, let's go back over the road, trap all the mines. Wait, I thought you were dead. You're not, apparently. Ooh, you look reflective. So we no longer have the extra activated ability that we used to get from our old helmets. Instead, we have a boatload more armor. I think I'm happier with the defensive increase in this, but nope, just having an extra thing to cycle through. I do miss it for a little bit. Mythical Cotonian Threat Sash. Lifestealer Nova. I do like Lifestealer Nova. Unfortunately, this is a bit of a mixed bag in terms of other things we get from it, so nope, it's not gonna go in. A Transformer. Well, it has a boatload of life. That's the problem with these things. It's also ether resistant. That's also a bit of an issue. Let's see if we just try to take it out and just get a bit of a feel for just how much effort it's gonna take. It does decent damage. That wheel spinny attack. Okay, actually it looked more potent than it really was. And down it goes. It took about a full bar of energy and quite a lot of time. Interesting. Also means I'm probably gonna ignore them. Ooh, look at that. I was looking for a portal. I found myself a portal. Okay, so I'm gonna go into the portal and then we're also gonna go into the Obsidian Throne. And after that, we head on to the Necropolis. Ooh, Luxmere Nightmage. You are a named enemy. Also doing decent damage. Oh, wait. Wait. This is actually one. Nope. Okay. I think I mentioned before that one of the viewers died in here against something like this. Well, I think I found exactly who murdered that person. Because it is nearly happening to me as well. Crap. Okay, I cleared this, that is good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Get all those auras back up. Okay, my heart is pounding in my throat. Not a good thing. So the problem is it is a named enemy. A uniquely named enemy that has Arcane as a built-in. Okay, quiet my heart, quiet. Okay, it's a unique enemy that has Arcane built-in. So it is not easy to see that it is Arcane. So you think, hey, it's just a random hero. I can take random heroes. I've killed all the random heroes so far. And then your auras get stripped, then all your defenses are gone. And you're left with, well, having to really run for your life or die trying. Very, very happy it was indeed the running part that was successful here. So slow and steady, cautious approach back to where we were. Was somewhere around here. I think the boss probably ran back to the spawning location. So it's gonna be near the portal, lower on life than when we encountered it the first time. Okay, there was mortality. I have a couple of item-based defensive procs. So there's that. And we have the Defy Death from the Death Ward. That probably is one of those things that saved my life. Enemy. Looking for the enemy. Come on, I'm getting really, really nervous if we don't end up finding it. Because then I will forget about it and then I'll get murderized once I get out of the thing. So that's not an option. It must die. There it is. See? Luxmere Nightmage, you are dead. But it has the shadow step thing. So it hides among the enemies and then it just shadow steps towards you and backstabs you. Definitely one to watch out for. Oh boy. Okay, I was gonna ignore those things. Okay. Did we get anything for my... That's what I got myself as a mythical scythe of Tenebris. Plus one to all skills in Necromancer. Wait. Stop trying to murder me, you sneaky, sneaky zombies. Mythical scythe of Tenebris. Boatload of chaos damage. Life leech, physical to chaos conversion, health, offensive ability, skill cooldown reduction. It is a two-hander, but on a Reaper this could be very, very fun. Two-handed Reaper, bone harvest, shadow step. There's fun stuff there. Will we have enough bag space? I don't think we will have enough bag space. So let's actually head back to town. Down, 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 down. Homestead is good enough. Distance to vendors and to the stash is not too bad here. Actually, I think our starter town is probably going to be better. So I can sell all the things I know I will not end up using. Oh, funny enough, the threadbare sash is also one of those. Under Legion, nope, that's for a summoner. This is a shield, this is an offhand. Guns, 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 all the items. I think I'll try and save the sash. Body armors, I'm gonna ignore them because we have the Cloth of Unspeakable Invocation. It's basically only the shoulder pads that really could do with an upgrade or a weapon. Everything else is kind of bound to be a mythical. And even belts, there's the plus one to skills, that's not gonna randomly appear. Okay. Much, much better now.
See you around.
Then not use a portal, walk back to the fingerbing thing. Okay, the entire ordeal of running for my life did take quite a bit more time than I had expected it to. So let's go for plan B. I'll keep the portal here next to the entrance, then I'll walk to the necropolis waypoint. And then there we end this episode, and the next episode I'll just jump back and wrap it up. Okay, lots of damage was done. Oh wait, ground is of course not a happy place. Let's run. Let's leave that thing behind. My heart rate is still elevated from the encounter just a moment ago. That was... I think this was actually the... Well, we did Elite Graval. That was a very close encounter. But this was an unexpected close encounter. Those are the less pleasant ones. And it is, as you can see, it's one big light show on the screen. So enemies that are incredibly sneaky, they are really good at hiding since they just don't stick out. And then if they're arcane, then, well, it's gonna get you murderized. Usually, no, the entirety of the screen, it's very large. There's a lot of light shows, but the only bit of the screen that is really important to me is basically this bit, the health bar and the cooldowns on the skills. Most of the rest of the screen, I don't pay too much attention to it. Well, except maybe when I'm positioning myself. But most of the time, my focus is on the health bar. So having the things above it, it helps a little bit. But especially if you're focused on the screen up here, and most of the time, no, the health bar is not moving because we're draining a boatload of life. The sneaky buggers, they can get you. They can get you. Okay, at least the next waypoint has been obtained. That is good. So at this point, I'm going to thank you very much for watching. I'm very happy I'm now standing here rather than looking at the menu screen, because that would have been horrible. Next episode, we're going to dive into the realm of Catan. We're going to wrench a spirit out and clear the obsidian throne, which is always filled with lots of Catanic monsters. And having that chaos resistance at a solid 80% is going to be incredibly helpful there. So thank you very much for watching, and hope to see you again next episode. Bye bye.